Vipers lead the Stampede 41-33 with 5:46 to play here until halftime. Folks, the NBA Development League Green Week begins on Saturday, March the 26th, and runs through April the 2nd. The NBA Development League players across the league are wearing special green and white shooting shirts to raise awareness for the environment. Join the NBA family in raising awareness and protecting the environment. For more information, log on to the NBAcares.com website. That's NBAcares.com/green for more information on how you can get involved. Alex DeBario alongside Jonah Goldberg. Glad to have you aboard here on NBA Futurecast. We're here locally on Jack FM. Vipers again out to a 41-33 lead on the Idaho Stampede. And we talked about taking better care of the basketball. Only had one turnover in the first. They do have four turnovers here in the second quarter. Antoine Walker with the basketball for the Stampede. Five on the shot clock. Throws up a teardrop of the lane. Too strong off of the window. Got his own rebound and put it back up and in. So Antoine Walker, who's one for his first seven, makes another one there. He's got 5 points. There's Sullivan, now between the circles, Shire, right wing Richard Roby. Over the head pass now to McNeil. And we got a foul called on Bobbitt. And Bobbitt, with his prototypical words for the official after committing the foul, or I should say after being called for the foul. Here's Shire. DeFay hands it off for Roby. Sullivan. Bounce pass to Shire. Has it left wing in between the circles. McNeil's got to launch one as the shot clock was winding down to 1 second. Missed off the front of the rim. A rebound to Jenkins and the Idaho Stampede.
See the couple of Vipers that were looking for the rebound, both trying to get it with one hand, while Jackson grabs it with both hands. Easier to control.
Exactly. Banks, nice drop step underneath, and he scores off of the glass. 41-37 now, 4:30 to play here until halftime. John Shire with it in between the circles, throws it to McNeil, now out of the corner to Richard Roby. Roby skips it over to Shire, right wing, back quickly up top to McNeil. Takes a couple dribbles, pulls up left elbow, 16-footer off the mark. Rebound to Jackson. He'll bring it the other way with a head of steam. Jackson. Stops left elbow, leaving it back for Banks, top of the key. He'll drive it, finger roll layup, bounces around the top of the rim and falls in. Idaho within two at 41-39. Shire brings it across the timeline. Timeout taken by Coach Finch and the Vipers. We'll take one as well. No, it's a 20-second timeout. We'll keep it right here. So that's pretty good. Richard Roby has it for the Vipers into the post to Sullivan. Back to Roby. Left corner jumper for three. Bingo. Richard Roby from downtown. Hopefully the Vipers can build on that. Trying to build their lead back up. They lead at 44-39. 5-point advantage with 3:40 to play until halftime. Jackson dribbles right side. Back top of the key. Now to Walker. Trying to get a bounce pass into Banks. It was stolen away, but now Walker comes up with a steal at half court. They get it to Bobbitt. Right corner for three. Bingo. Tony Bobbitt from downtown. He's deadly from out there if you leave him open. 44-42. Here's Roby, left corner, trying to answer back with a triple. He's off the mark. Rebound to Antoine Walker, and the Stampede can tie or take the lead in this possession. Jackson on top of the center court logo, dribbles over to the left wing. Got McNeil on him defensively. Jackson tried to leave it back for Walker after his drive. Goes out of bounds. It'll stay with the Stampede when we come back. 2:57 to play until halftime. Vipers with a 44-42 lead on the Idaho Stampede. Stay with us. This is Vipers basketball on Jack FM. Antoine Walker ties the game at 44. That runner in the lane. Folks, Futurecast would not be possible without a couple of our league-wide sponsors providing all the images in stunning high definition. Panasonic providing all the HD cameras this year. Panasonic, ideas for life. And, of course, now in its fourth season, providing and capturing every single NBA Development League game, it's NewTek with the TriCaster. They call it the TV truck in a box. Capturing every NBA Development League game for Futurecast in its fourth season, so you can watch all of the players absolutely free for those who are in pursuit of amazing. Tied at 44, 2:26 to play until halftime. Alex Sobario alongside Jonah Goldberg. Glad to have you aboard here. A tight one now here at the farm as McNeil unties the game at 45-44. Vipers have led by as many as 11. McNeil back to the line. Second free throw is in and out. Rebound grabbed by Banks and leaving it back for Cedric Jackson. It's Bobbitt right side. Bounce pass to Jenkins on the wing, in between the circles to Jackson, left side Banks into the post, Antoine Walker left block, backing it in on Sullivan, into the lane, that's blocked by Sullivan. They call a foul, and Antoine Walker's going to the free throw line. That looked like a clean rejection from here.
And that draws the ire of the State Farm Arena faithful.
We'll call Ashim Thabit off of the bench. As again, Sullivan now picks up his third foul. Thabit has three fouls.
What does it say that you have two centers with three fouls, one center on the bench, and you're putting a guy with three fouls out there?
Then you want to protect Sullivan here for the second half. He's more accustomed to what's going on around here. And remember Coach Finch's motto, or mantra, that if you're an NBA assignment player, you're going to get your 20 minutes, and everything after that you've got to earn. John Shire with the basketball in between the circles. We're tied at 45 here at the State Farm Arena. McNeil on the left baseline, bounce pass that went through the legs of Banks. They get it to the corner to John Shire. Seven on the shot clock, launches the three, top the back of the rim. Rebound to Bobbitt, and Idaho can reclaim the lead here on this possession with a bucket. Jackson underneath quickly to Jenkins, out to Walker, top of the key for three, off the back of the rim. Roby grabs the rebound. Walker struggling tonight with his shot.
He's gotten some open looks too, they're just not going in.
Shire around the pick from Thabit. Has it right of the circle, now leaving it back from McNeil. Bounce pass now to Shire, right wing for three, off the back iron. Ball batted out over to Shire. Ball's loose on the floor. Bobbitt gets on the floor, calls the timeout. Smart play, veteran play there from Bobbitt. Former Cincinnati Bearcat calling the 22nd timeout here.
Time for your in-game injury update, sponsored by Dr. Michael Sander, Sander Orthopedics, the official team orthopedic surgeon of the Rio Grande Valley Vipers. We talked a bit about Matt Janning returning from his high left ankle sprain, but back to the wave due to injury department, Marquise Gilstrap, that left knee injury that he had suffered in training camp. Thought he was ready to go, played five games, flared up again though. Not sure if he'll be able to return this season.
Vipers really like him though. We talked about him being, you know, the second round pick in the draft. Still retain his D-League rights for next year.
Good person, a good player too. Got some talent.
Yeah, we saw flashes of it. Different stages over the last few games here in this homestand. We're tied at 45 with a minute 14 to go until halftime. Get it into Cedric Jackson here, and he'll bring it up for the Stampede as they try to reclaim the lead. Jackson on the left wing, in between the circles to Banks. Muhammad Fay guarding him. Banks now to Jenkins. To Banks, right wing. He'll take the three off the back of the rim. Fay grabs the rebound. Now Shire will walk it up. Angle dribble left, hands it off to McNeil. High side left wing to the corner. John Shire. Jackson giving him the baseline if he wants it. Shire leaves it back to McNeil. Seven on the shot clock, 38 seconds to go in the period. McNeil will make his move. Take it up top. Now to Fay, right wing for three. No good. Too strong. Rebound. Cedric Jackson had it. Richard Roby got his hands in there, and they're going to call a jump ball. So Roby and Jackson will jump it up here with 29.7 remaining until halftime.
Roby got that ball out of his hands, but it wasn't until after the whistle was blown.
Substitution here is Joe Dabbert will come in. We picked up three fouls pretty quickly in that first quarter. Randy Livingston, the head coach of the Stampede, says, steal it, and that's exactly what they did. Tarver has it now for the Stampede. 23 seconds into Jenkins, who was open, now kicked it out to Bobbitt, who was more open, and hits the three for the Stampede. Tony Bobbitt from the outside gives the Stampede the 48-45 lead with 12 seconds to play until the intermission. McNeil and the Vipers will play for the last shot. He's got it on the center court logo. Bobbitt giving him the right side. McNeil on the drive, throws it up, off the glass, no good. Ball batted out. Ball is loose. Bobbitt's going to let it fly. It won't count even if it goes. It hits only glass. Again, got it off after the buzzer anyway, but wow, a tough second quarter, a tough end of the second quarter for Rio Grande Valley. They give up what is one point in this game was an 11-point advantage. They go into the intermission trailing 48-45 to the Idaho Stampede, and a big part of that comeback was the play, again, of Cedric Jackson distributing the ball there. And you look at the way that they've played throughout as a team. Tony Bobbitt knocking down some shots. Luke Babbitt had a good first quarter, but really wasn't involved in the second. They've had to get a lot of guys involved. And take a look at Luke Babbitt as he comes off the floor right now. Babbitt hanging on to that right leg is heavily taped right now, and he's iced.